Okay, well, let's get started. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain amma ba'du. Rabbi syrahli sadri wa yasirli amri wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Hi, good morning everyone. Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
All right. Okay, so we have Mbak Salsabila, Mas Adam, lalu Mbak Al-Mahdiyah Hasana, Mbak Wardah, Mbak Halima Akhira, bukan ya? Oke, okay. Mas Satria, and then Mbak Yayi. So in this classroom we have Mbak Mahadewi Putri Anjani and then Mas Akbar ya. Alright, oke. Okay. Sayang ya, harusnya kameranya dua begini bisa menyorot. Oke lah, nanti saya beli tripod dulu. Alright, oke. Okay. How are you today? Is everything good?
I am fine, ma'am. Thank you. And you?
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. All good. Thank you for asking. All right. So today we're going to discuss your work. So you have to do something, I think. You need to write a paragraph that consists of topic sentence. Yes, a topic sentence and then supporting details and conclusions using one of the tricks how to develop supporting details. Do you still remember the three ways how to develop supporting sentence?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what are they? Mbak Al-Mahdiyah?
Explanation, detail, and example.
Good. So we have details, explanations, and also what ones? Examples.
Example.
Examples, yeah. Details, explanations, example. So you are going to present your development of paragraph. Anyone of you want to share yours? Adam, seems you want to present yours.
Huh? Oh, saya.
Silakan, Adam. Seems you want to present yours.
Jadi ini saya share screen apa enggak, Bu? Enggak usah.
Yeah, share screen.
Saya baca.
Share screen dong.
Oh, iya Bu. Oke, Bu. Siap, Bu.
Sudah saya set multiple participants? Can you make it bigger?
Sudah terlihat, Bu.
Sudah terlihat? Can you make it bigger? Oke. Okay,
apakah good. Sudah besar, Bu?
Sudah.
Alright, jadi ini saya baca, Bu. Freedom is necessary and important in my life. Freedom makes me do whatever I want without everyone getting in my way. Freedom let me do a lot of mistakes and reckless things, which will give me a life lesson and make me wiser in life. Freedom let me express my feelings and ideas freely because I don't care what other people think. Freedom allows me to think peacefully. If I choose not to think about anything else, I will be focused and able to make the right decision. Freedom leads to enhanced expression of creativity and original thoughts, increased productivity, and overall high quality of life. Freedom allows me to be myself. That is why I cherish freedom with all my heart.
Okay, good. So, can you spot? So what is the way that Adam used to develop his paragraph for the supporting details? Is that examples? Is there any examples?
No, there is no example.
No examples. Apa? Ada yang bisa? Yes.
Explanations.
Yes. Good. Explanations. Is it correct, Adam? Is that using explanations?
Yes. Explanation. Correct.
Explanation. Tapi nggak bisa. Yang offline nggak bisa mendengar suaranya ini ya? Oh ya udah. Mas ini. Gak apa? Nggak. Masih dengar. Oke. Okay. Alright. Okay. So it is explanations. Alright. Where is the topic sentence?
The topic sentence is Freedom is necessary and important in my life.
Okay, freedom is necessary and important in my life. So that's the topic sentence. So Adam tried to explain why it is why freedom is necessary and important in his life. Okay, so let's read one by one. Freedom is necessary and important in my life. Freedom makes me do whatever I want without everyone getting in my way. Freedom let me do a lot of mistakes and reckless things. Nah, itu kenapa tiba-tiba setelah titik, itu titik atau koma?
Titik.
Titik. Lalu kok tiba-tiba which will? Which itu menerangkan apa?
Oh, itu koma, Bu. Itu koma, Bu.
Koma.
Koma, koma, Bu.
Oke, berarti direvisi ya. Tapi di sini titik apa koma itu?
Yang mana, Bu?
Ya, yeah, things itu. Is that full stop or koma?
Koma, Bu.
Oke.
Okay. Betul apa koma? Salah?
Koma betul kalau koma. Things, comma, which will give me a life lesson and make me wiser in life. Freedom, let me express my feelings and ideas freely because I don't. Nah itu kalau di academic writing tidak boleh ada constructions. Do you remember that, Adam? Don't.
A little bit.
Jadi kalau di academic writing tidak boleh disingkat-singkat. Misalkan I am, tidak boleh. I'm, begitu tidak boleh. I apostrophe M, begitu tidak boleh. Lalu don't harus ditulisnya lengkap. Gimana? I do not care. Betul. Remember, kalau di everyday life, you can use constructions. Boleh disingkat-singkat. Misalkan nulis status atau nulis selain hal yang akademis, boleh disingkat. Tapi karena mata kuliah ini tujuannya adalah untuk academic writing, so no constructions. Right? Then I don't care what other people think. Freedom allows me to think peacefully. If I choose not to think about anything else, I will be focused and able to make the right decisions. Right? Freedom leads to enhanced expressions of creativity and original thought, increased productivity and overall high quality of life. Okay? Freedom allows me to be myself. That is why I cherish freedom with all my heart. So, is the last sentence your concluding sentence?
Yes, ma'am. Hmm.
Okay, itu paraphrase dari topic sentence ya. Okay. Sudah bagus, Adam. That's cool. Any comments from the other students? Tidak. Right. Okay. Thank you, Adam, for sharing. Right. So now, anyone else? Rahma Atika, do you want to share yours? Kok sekarang off screen? Do you want to share yours?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Kenapa, Mbak? Details. Masih ingat kemarin kalau apa bedanya detail sama examples? Kalau kemarin explanations. Kalau details memberikan details, contohnya kemarin seperti gym itu loh, kok gym apa? Health center itu. Dia memberikan fasilitas apa saja, itu details. Explanations, dia explaining meaning. Misalkan si Adam tadi bilang, freedom is important in my life. Ya, menjelaskan. Menjelaskan freedom dalam hal apa, misalkan begitu. Kalau beda paragraf bisa. Kalau dalam satu paragraf, what do you think? Mungkin dalam dalam hal yang kompleks bisa mungkin ya. Biasanya kan dijelaskan artinya dulu, meaningnya dulu, lalu kemudian contohnya. Oke, okay, bisa. You can mix. Tapi dalam kita belajar ini satu-satu dulu mungkin ya. satu-satu dulu aja. Biar terlihat mana dikembangkannya dengan cara apa begitu. Silakan Mbak Rahma, if you want to share your. Essay writing. Bisa diperbesar Mbak Rahma? Nah, iya tadi. Lagi? Oke, cukup. Can you please read?
The meaning of freedom in my life is free to have any choice about ourselves, but we have the limitation. Freedom have the broad meaning, namely free to express some ideas and suggestion, free to choose some choices, and free to socialize with other people or other society. Freedom have the good impact and bad impact to our life. The good impact of freedom are like every people can socialize well and be confident with others, get many new experience and lessons of life that we can take it. The bad impact of freedom are like promiscuity, the bad environment, there is some problem in the home or broken home, get less affection and attention from the parents and family. Finally, each people have the different means of freedom in their mind, but it is all depends of the people if they can control themselves that they will be in a good impact of freedom, but if they do not can control themselves that they will be in the bad impact of freedom means.
All right, okay, thank you Mbak Rahma. So guys, what do you think as the is the paragraph development, which ways that Mbak Rahma use explanations? Do you think so? Explanations? Is it, Mbak Rahma? Is it explanations?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So let's discuss one by one. Let's read it together. Ke atas, Mbak Rahma. The meaning of freedom in my life is free to have any choice about ourselves, but we have the limitations. So topic sentence-nya berarti yang mana? Main idea-nya yang mana? Itu topiknya, main idenya, free to have any choice, but we have the limitations. Okay. Alright, freedom have atau has. Jadi freedom itu singular atau plural? Singular sepertinya ya. Freedom has the broad meaning, namely free to express some ideas and suggestions, free to choose some choices, and free to socialize with other people or other society. Bagus. Freedom have. Coba nanti dicek. Sepertinya has ya. Freedom has the good has good impact. Kenapa pakai the? Apa bedanya pakai the sama tidak? No. Anyone else? Why do we need to use the and without the? Itu pelajaran grammar ya, structure semester 1, semester 2. The sama without the.
I think the used for the specific one, Miss.
Good. That's the idea. Specific atau biasanya sudah dimention di awal, lalu Anda ingin mengulangi lagi, itu pakai the. Misalkan, the banana we ate yesterday was delicious. Itu spesifik, oh banana yang mana sih? Oh yang kemarin kita makan itu loh. Gitu. Kalau kita sekedar mengatakan apple, an apple is nutritious for our health, misalnya begitu. Kita nggak pakai the, karena we talk about apple in general. Gitu ya. An apple is nutritious for our health. Jadi tidak pakai the karena generalisasi gitu. Kalau kita bilang, hey, do you know guys, the banana we ate yesterday was very delicious. Oh, merujuk pada banana yang kemarin itu loh, gitu. Sama kaitannya dengan ini, freedom has good impact and bad impact to our life. Harusnya menurut saya tidak pakai the. What do you think? Is that the thing you understand why we use the and know the? Itu ya, oke. Okay. The good impact. Nah, kalau sudah di bagus ini. Kenapa dia pakai the? Karena sudah dimention di sini. The good impact of freedom are like every people can socialize well and be confident with others, get many new experience and lessons. Experience itu bisa plural enggak? Bisa pakai S enggak? Experience. Bisa.
Bisa.
Kalau bisa, jadi kalau N itu harus paralel. Jadi N itu adalah menggabungkan sesuatu yang paralel. Misalkan kalau Anda bilang experience, kalau mau tanpa S, nggak apa-apa, tapi lessonnya juga tanpa S. Misalkan sebelum N itu adalah noun, setelahnya juga noun. Sebelum N itu adjective, setelah N-nya juga adjective. Jadi menggabungkan dua hal yang paralel. Okay. Seperti or juga begitu. Okay. And then experiences and lessons of life that we can took, betul enggak? Can took. Can take. Karena can apa? Modal. Setelah modal auxiliary tambah verb 1. Ya. Yeah. Seperti enggak bisa kita juga bilang can to take begitu enggak bisa. Can tambah can itu langsung karena modal langsung dia bare infinitive. Bare infinitive itu bukan to infinitive. Masih ingat ya pelajaran grammar? Oke. Okay. So we can take it. Good. The bad impact. Nah, bagus dia pakai the karena bad impact sudah pernah dimention di situ. The bad impact of freedom are like promiscuity. What is that, Mbak Rahma? Saya sendiri enggak tahu. Promiscuity, what is that? Apa Mbak Rahma? Lupa. Mbak Rahma nulis tapi lupa. Ada yang tahu promiscuity? The bad impact of freedom are like promiscuity. Ada yang bisa search promiscuity apa? Nah, apa yang perlu ditingkatkan dari sentence ini? The bad impact of freedom are like promiscuity, comma, the bad environment, comma, there is some problem in the home or broken home, comma, get less affections and attention from parents and family.
Pergaulan bebas, ma'am.
Promiscuity pergaulan, huh? Nggak perlu? Betul. Anda tadi Mas Akbar sama Mbak Hime sudah men-support apa yang salah begitu. Apa yang perlu diingatkan? Ingat, jadi kita mau menulis itu harus efektif. The bad impact of freedom are like promiscuity. Kan noun. Satu kata aja kan, promiscuity. Lalu koma, menurut saya the-nya ini dihilangkan karena tidak spesifik kemana kan. Bad environment boleh, ini kan frase. Lalu yang selanjutnya, kok dia sentence? There is some problem in the home or broken home. Get less affections and attention from parents and family. Jadi harus konsisten. Kalau misalkan satu kata aja. Kalau mau pakai frase, frase aja. Gitu. Jadi kalau kita bisa singkatkan, efektifkan kalimat ini menjadi gimana? Kita bisa pakai like promiscuity, bad environment. Lalu there is some problem in the home or broken home itu kita squeeze jadi apa kira-kira? some personal problem. Gitu? Mungkin bisa begitu. Lalu yang selanjutnya, get less affection and attention. Less affection and attention juga bisa sebenarnya. Yeah. Jadi maksud saya tidak kemudian ada yang kata, ada yang frase, ada yang sentence bentuknya. Jadi diefektifkan, the bad impact of freedom are like promiscuity, bad environment, some personal problem, less affection and attention. Sudah, titik. Oke. Okay. Teman-teman yang online ada yang ditanyakan? Atau paham nggak maksud saya tadi? Mbak Wardah, poin saya tadi apa? Wardah, are you there? Mbak Yayi, Juwita, do you understand what I mean?
Yes, ma'am.
Apa? Coba diulangi, maksud saya yang tadi di kalimat ini apa? Are you belong to this class? Oh, ya silakan, silakan. Gak apa. Maksud saya dari koreksi tadi apa? Atau siapa yang mau menyampaikan, siapa ya?
Can I, ma'am?
Silakan, siapa ini?
Rebecca.
Rebecca, silakan Rebecca.
To make it effective and parallel.
Jadi biar efektif dan paralel, sehingga kalau memang menggunakan satu kata saja, atau satu kata boleh dibarengi dengan frase, begitu ya. Right. Jadi tidak mix up antara satu kata, frase, dan juga sentence. Alright, thank you. Selanjutnya, betul ini Mbak Rahma, boleh. Agak panjang begitu, tapi bukan sentence kan. Less affection and attention from parents and family. From the parents and family, boleh begitu? Agak bentuknya panjang, tapi dia bukan sentence. Ya, yeah. Tetap frase itu kan? Good. Boleh Mbak Rahma begitu?
Apakah tetap pakai the atau tidak?
Pakai the nggak apa-apa, karena parents itu jelas ya. From the parents and family. Mungkin boleh, terserah, karena kalau parents kan parents, orang tua. Kalau family kan extended. Ada istilah itu nuclear family sama extended family. Do you understand that? Apa bedanya? Nuclear. Betul. Jadi kalau nuclear, jadi istilahnya keluarga inti. Keluarga inti itu bahasa Inggrisnya nuclear family. Nuclear. Anda tahu nuclear? Adore nuclear. Nuclear. Tulisannya seperti itu. Nuclear family itu keluarga inti terdiri dari parents sama anak. Itu nuclear family. Extended family. Itu ya. Okay. So finally each. Karena people berarti enggak each. Apa? Sebentar. Each itu kan, bisa nggak each people? Each itu kan harusnya singular. Every people, each person. Yeah. Each person, kalau di situ person berarti have-nya diganti apa? Ganti? Has. Has, betul. Has, karena singular. Yeah. Each person has. Pakai the enggak?
No, I think.
No, good. Has different means of freedom in. Pakai their atau pakai apa? Karena person. Their-nya ke person. Tadi kan ke people, betul pakai their. Kalau sekarang apa? Karena person berarti tidak pakai their. Pakai apa?
He.
Biasanya kalau saya his, tanda garing. His or her. Karena person kan bisa female or male begitu. Tapi kalau mau satu saja juga nggak apa-apa, silakan. Her mind. Okay, but it this all depends It is all about it. It all depends. It all depends of the people. Maksudnya gimana nih? Finally, each person has different means of freedom in his or her mind, but it depends on gitu kayaknya. It depends, but it depends on the pen. It depends on the person, gitu ya. Kayaknya titik ya setelah ini ya. Ya, titik. Lalu if they bisa diganti apa? Kan tadi people, terus kan kita ganti person berarti if. Atau bisa juga diganti someone begitu. If she or he can control. Their self itu tidak ada, yang ada apa? Themselves, ya, yeah, themselves. If he or she can control his or her him, sorry, himself ya berarti ya. Koma. Karena setelah if ya, they will, that-nya dihilangkan. Nah, di atasnya tadi saya ingin komentari but di sini ya. If she or if he or she can control herself or himself, she will be in a good impact of freedom. Kan di atasnya tadi udah pakai but ya. Anda pakai kata apa untuk mempertentangkan? Kan but itu kata pertentangan. Bisa pakai apa? Biar enggak but. In contrast, however, biasanya kalau di tengah-tengah kalimat tuh pakai however, however, atau yet paling mudah, ya kan? Sering pakai yet nggak? Nggak. Pakai, dipakai bisa. Atau yet bisa, yet if they don't, if they cannot apa do not, Mbak Rama? If they cannot atau do not control. Oh, tadi pakainya she ya. If he or she cannot cannot itu dipisah apa di spasi? Digabung ya. Digabung Mbak Rama. Jadi cannot itu digabung. Betul. Cannot control him herself or him herself. Koma. Agak ribet ya kalau pakai ini. He. Koma berarti enggak pakai they. Right, okay. Itu konklusinya Mbak Rama. Is the last sentence your conclusions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Alright, okay. Begitu ya. Atau Mbak Rama ada yang ditanyakan? It's all good. Right. Thank you, Mbak Rama, for sharing. Sekarang kita ke Kok teman-teman yang offline sharing nggak kelihatan ya jadinya? Harus ikut Zoom dulu. Kalau nulis juga nggak bisa. Oke, sementara teman-teman yang online saja dulu. We have, berapa ini? 6-7. We have 7 students here. Silakan, siapa lagi? Rebecca, do you want to share yours? Saya izin foto ya untuk laporan. Jadi kami diminta untuk memfasilitasi mahasiswa offline. Alright, siapa? Rebecca, do you want to share yours? Tidak. Siapa yang mau? Silakan. Mbak Almahdia.
Can I try, okay, ma'am?
Okay, Salsa, Salsa, terus Mbak Almahdia ya. Yes, ma'am. Salsa, silakan. Salsabila Adiyanti. Teman-teman, kalau diberi feedback, jangan sakit hati ya. Oke, okay? Gak apa-apa. Karena apa? Writing itu rentan dengan motivasi. Biasanya kalau sudah diberi feedback itu mungkin merasa malu dan agak inferior gitu. Saya harapkan jangan. Jadi mumpung ada di kelas essay writing, mumpung masih belajar, gak apa-apa. Ya memang kunci belajar bahasa itu harus membuat kesalahan. So then you learn. But can you make it bigger, Mbak Salsa? Masih belum kelihatan.
Yes, ma'am.
Dibesarkan lagi bisa, Mbak?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Kelihatan, teman-teman? Lumayan. Oke. Okay. Silakan, Mbak.
Living without a network on the island is an unusual vacation. Living without a network on the on the island is an unusual vacation. For example, my first time felt a vacation with my friends to the island in 10 days. We could not contact whoever it was. Moreover, we used electricity until the afternoon, because we could not use it after 6. Our night became very dark and our activity was discontinued. There is a little local society who has a generator to light their house, but no little society whose houses are so dark. They have some electric objects, but they do not work. We spent our vacation comfortably because our job was not only for it, but to teach the local society of that island. In sum, a vacation without using a network is an unusual and unforgettable experiment for me.
Right, okay, thank you, Mbak Salsa. Kita diskusikan satu persatu ya. What do you think? What does Mbak Salsa Bila use to develop her paragraph?
Examples
ya. Is that examples, Mbak Salsa?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, karena di situ sudah ada for example. Okay, let's discuss it together. Living without a network on the island is an unusual vacation. Okay, ini judulnya. Lalu, living without a network on the island is an unusual vacation. For example, my first time. Kenapa ada felt di sini? What do you mean by felt?
My first time felt. Merasakan memang. I think yeah. My first time doing vacation in 10 days inside the island.
Felt mungkin agak terimbas bahasa Indonesia kita ya. Mungkin. Makanya Mbak Salsa ini menuliskan felt. Mungkin bisa gini, for example, my first experience of vacation with my friends to the islands. Kenapa the islands? On the islands. Kenapa Mbak Salsa nggak menyebutkan specific islands apa misalkan? My first experience. My experience of vacation with my friends to Bali Islands misalkan gitu. To Bali Islands in 10 days. Gitu ya. Masadian Islands in 10 days. What is it, Masadian?
One of the island in Soti, Sulawesi, ma'am.
Ah, you are from Sulawesi. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
We could not contact whoever it was. Nah, kenapa it was? Whoever.
Yes, ma'am.
Kenapa it ini kemana? What does it refer to?
I just think siapapun itu the mean who it, whoever it was.
Whoever, gimana? Yes. Ada saran dari teman-teman? Hah? Gitu. We couldn't contact.
Sorry ma'am, I couldn't hear. I cannot hear your voice.
Yang saya bingungkan adalah it was, whoever it was. It-nya refer ke, harusnya merujuk ke sesuatu atau ada nggak sebelumnya? We couldn't contact any people. Mungkin begitu ya. Yeah, we cannot contact any people. Anda tahu bedanya any sama some misalkan gitu. Any itu
maybe ada any negatif
kan? Apa tuh? Ada negatifnya, kesan negatif. We couldn't contact karena dia couldn't ya. Couldn't contact any people. Moreover, we used electricity ditambahkan maksudnya di sini kami menggunakan si listrik hanya sampai siang gitu aja, gitu kah?
Yes, ma'am.
Moreover, we use electricity only until the afternoon. Okay, itu sebelum because kenapa ada koma? Setelah afternoon kenapa ada koma?
I think to sentence.
Karena tidak ada aturan, correct me if I'm wrong ya, tidak ada aturan sebelum because itu koma begitu. Jadi menurut saya komanya dihilangkan. Jadi because-nya kan menyambungkan ya, menyambungkan. Moreover, we use electricity only until the afternoon because we couldn't use it after 6. Okay. Our night became very dark. Nah, kenapa sebelum n ada koma?
Same.
Sama seperti ini.
Yeah.
Padahal what do you think? Do we use comma or not?
I think because after after n, if we use n, there is a comma before n.
Kalau gimana? Argumennya si Mbak Salsa tadi, tentu nggak usah denger ya berarti. Serius?
Si Mbak Salsa bila saya kan tanya, kenapa pakai? Can you listen to my voice?
Yes, ma'am.
Jadi si Mbak Salsa bila itu, saya tanya kenapa di sini sebelum n itu ada koma, lalu Mbak Salsa bila menjawab karena sebelum n itu ada koma. Kenapa? Kalau n pakai koma itu kalau dia paralel, misalkan apa? Menyebutkannya berurutan. Itu baru koma. Tapi ada yang berpendapat juga nggak ada koma. Tapi kalau dalam konteks ini kan tidak begitu ya. Ini konteksnya kan tidak paralelism ya. Berarti what do you think? Pakai koma atau tidak? Our night
no, ma'am.
Very dark and our activity was
discontinued.
Maksudnya gimana?
Maksudnya kan seperti dihentikan.
kayaknya kata discontinued ini yang kurang aneh ya. Was cancelled atau apa gitu. Activity discontinued. Bisa? Nanti coba double check. Jadi, stop gitu. Coba di Oxford, di Advanced Oxford Dictionary online itu, teman-teman bisa search collocations. Collocations itu untuk melihat, oh biasanya activity itu pasangannya apa sih? Gitu. Kalau sense kita mungkin nggak dapat juga ya, misalkan melakukan kejahatan, what do you say? Crime, kejahatannya, melakukannya. Is it do crime? Ternyata tidak, ternyata apa? Apa? Commit a crime gitu. Jadi di Oxford tuh ada begitu, ada pasangan namanya collocations. Jadi coba nanti dicek ya, activity bisa nggak discontinued? Gitu. Okay. There is a little local society who has a generator to light their house. Says, berarti gitu ya? What do you think? Is it their house or their houses? There is a little local society. Jadi little itu sedikit, tapi lebih dari satu kan?
Iya.
Berarti houses. Houses. Little itu lawan katanya dari much. Much itu kan banyak. Little itu bukan satu. Little itu banyak tapi sedikit. Berarti kan lebih dari satu. Little walaupun ada society berarti. Their houses, but no little society whose itu gimana? But no little society whose houses are so dark. Maksudnya
begini, mem, little houses has a generator, but no little the mean many people, mem, houses are so dark.
Saya nggak paham. Ada sedikit masyarakat yang punya generator untuk
ya mem, tapi tidak sedikit juga yang rumahnya gelap gitu mem, yang nggak punya generator.
Gimana membuat kalimat ini efektif? Maksud Mbak Salsabila, saya bisa menangkap bahwa ada yang punya generator untuk menerangi rumah mereka, tapi ada juga yang tidak. Gimana? While the others do not don't gitu. Well, the others don't gitu. Gimana?
From
you do not. Membacanya don't. Do not. Membaca do not tuh kayak enggak enak. Okay. Well, the others
from where, ma'am?
Dari but-nya itu diganti while the others do not.
What mean well?
While.
While.
U H I L E. Yeah.
While. Yes, while well, the others
do not.
Do not.
Titik. Nah itu. Nah kalimatnya lebih efektif ya. What do you think? Is that more effective than the first one? Daripada yang tadi lah. Kan sulit dipahami yang tadi ya.
Yes, ma'am.
Lalu kalimat selanjutnya adalah they have some electric objects but they do not work. Ini gimana maksudnya?
Kayak punya benda-benda listrik gitu, ma'am, tapi tidak bekerja.
Ini enggak, maksud saya kenapa kalimat ini dimunculkan? Ada beberapa masyarakat yang punya generator untuk menerangi rumahnya, tapi yang lain tidak. Lalu, signifikansi dari kalimat ini, they have some electric objects. Ini kembali ke they-nya ini kembali ke society, ke masyarakat yang nggak punya generator itu kah?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, they have some electric objects, betul. But they do not work, betul they. Karena they-nya kembali ke objects-nya tadi. Ya? But they do not work. Okay. We spend our vacation comfortably because our job was not only for it, but to teach the local society of that island. Can you please explain the sentence, Mbak Salsa?
We spend our vacation comfortably, but because our job was not. Jadi, Mem, kita ke island itu bukan untuk vacation, bukan untuk holiday, but to teach the local society of that island.
Anda kayak PMM gitu kah? Melakukan KKN gitu kah?
Not. Like.
We spend our vacations. Nggak, maksudnya nggak ada kalimat pengantarnya ya, terus kok tiba-tiba because our job was not only for eat, but to teach the local society of that island. Harusnya ada kalimat pengantar dulu ya. Gimana? Ada yang punya ide? We spend our... Enggak, kalimatnya Anda mulai dengan we spend our vacation comfortably. Lalu kemudian keterangannya, because, karena our job was not only for it, but it is the local society of that island. Jadi kurang ada pengantarnya dulu, kok tiba-tiba not only to teach, but not only apa for vacation, but also to teach that the society of that island. Agak gimana? Kalau orang baca itu agak jam gitu Mbak, idenya. Ya, coba itu di highlight kuning nanti bisa diperbaiki Mbak Salsa. Di highlight, terserah warna kuning atau warna apapun. Itu ya. Oke, okay. In sum, betul. Boleh ini bagus kalau ada kata in conclusion atau in sum gitu ya. Bahasanya sum ya, bukan sum. In sum, a vacation without using network. What do you think? Using perlu dipakai nggak? Without network, langsung ya. In sum, a vacation without network. Jadi using a-nya di ano, di network cuma pakai e. Okay. Without a network is an unusual. Unusualnya diganti saja Mbak. Kan itu sudah ada unforgettable ya. Unusualnya dihilangkan karena repetitions ya. Jadi ingat konklusi itu intinya sama dengan topic sentence tapi penggunaan kalimatnya berbeda. Jadi salah satu caranya bisa menggunakan sinonim. Nah, kan unusual jadi tidak perlu dimention lagi tapi menggunakan kata lain itu sudah ada unforgettable experiment atau experience.
Experience, ma'am.
Okay. Experience for good. Itu sudah bagus Mbak Salsa. Thank you. Ada yang ditanyakan lagi Mbak Salsa?
No, ma'am. Yeah. This is same. This is kan I use past sentence while the others do not or didn't not.
Oh, didn't.
They all did not.
Did not, yeah.
Did not, ma'am.
Yes, ini juga there is, there was berarti.
This is same.
There is berarti pakai past tense semuanya ya.
Yes,
there was a little society who had a generator.
Who had? If to like.
Enggak. Kalau to tetap dia dipasangkan dengan verb satu. Okay, sudah.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Ada yang mau share lagi? Mungkin satu lagi ya. Siapa? No one? Viola? Nada? Ahmadiyah ya tadi? Mbak Madia? Silakan Mbak Madia. Lupa saya, sorry. Waktu-waktu sudah selesai yang offline? Sudah selesai paragrafnya. Sudah? Itu belum. Gak apa-apa kalau belum, nanti diselesaikan. Sudah? Ada yang belum? Belum, gak apa-apa. Nanti yang setelah ini disubmit versi revisinya, kalau yang sudah revisi, berarti kalau yang belum dikerjakan. Silakan Mbak, siapa tadi? Al-Mahdiyah. Dibesarkan bisa Mbak? Kecil banget.
It is okay, ma'am.
Besar lagi bisa?
Oh, yes.
If it is possible. Yeah.
Yes. First, I'm sorry because my paragraph is so short.
Enggak apa-apa. Yang penting detailnya, caranya benar.
Okay. Swimming is an activity that I don't like. Swimming is an activity in the air that requires a lot of energy and strong stamina. In addition, swimming often makes the ears easily clogged with water, so I become less comfortable with swimming. Swimming also quickly makes...
Freezing. Hilang. Yang hilang saya atau mereka? Jangan-jangan. Halo, cek-cek. Jangan-jangan saya. Oh, bisa-bisa.
I still confused, ma'am, when I do the conclusion.
Oh, sudah selesai bacanya tadi ya? Tadi sempat nge-freeze gitu. Oke. Tadi sempat nge-freeze. Can you please repeat, Mbak Al-Mahdiyah, dari... Dari ini, swimming also quickly makes?
Yes, ma'am. Swimming also quickly makes the body feel tired. This happens because the activity in the water is exhausting. Besides, I also have bad memories of swimming in the past. In the past, where I drowned while swimming. And in conclusion, despite the many benefits of swimming, swimming is still an activity that I do not like.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Right. Okay. Thank you, Mbak Al-Mahdiyah. Swimming is an activity that I don't like. Berarti ini ya, ini topic sentence-nya sudah di-highlight sama Mbak Al-Mahdiyah. So this is activity that I don't like. Berarti akan menjelaskan detail tentang why Mbak Al-Mahdiyah doesn't like swimming. Okay. Berarti ini pengembangan paragrafnya pakai apa? Metode apa? Explanations. Good, thank you.
Explanation.
Thank you. Begitu Mbak Madia?
Yes, ma'am.
Swimming is an activity in the air.
Water.
Air atau water ya?
Water.
Air udara.
Kayaknya freezing lagi Mbak Madia. Swimming is an activity in the water that requires a lot of energy and strong stamina. Tapi betul ya kalimatnya ya. In addition, betul, ini sudah pakai transition. Jadi teman-teman kalau pakai transition, boleh. Swimming often makes the ears easily clogged with water, so I become less comfortable with swimming. Okay? So, swimming also quickly makes the body feel tired. Body feels, mungkin ya. All right. Mbak Madia is out from the Zoom. Okay, jadi nggak bisa. Okay, kita nggak bisa lanjutkan ya, berarti hilang tulisannya. Mungkin tadi apa yang saya notice ya? Kalimat terakhir tadi yang ingin saya komentari. Nanti aja kalau Mbak Madia balik, kalau nggak balik ya sudah. Satu lagi mungkin. Siapa? Halima? Desti? Viola? Yayi? Belum? Silakan. Dari Zoom. Saya change Zoom. Mas Akbar mau share. Join Zoom dulu. Ini mungkin sulitnya ya, saya juga bingung pakai alat apa nih. Alat apa? Pakai alat apa biar teman-teman bisa ya nggak ada alatnya ya. Ya harus join Zoom akhirnya. Akbar sudah join, silakan di share. Info KHS sudah bisa diklik sudah. Sudah. Can you please read? Dibaca dulu. Okay, is it all? Sudah itu. Kita baca satu-satu. Everyone can get freedom to do something. Topik sen, topiknya mana?
Freedom.
Main idenya? Gimana? Jadi Anda pengen mengembangkan paragraf tentang apa, Mas Akbar? Oh, berarti itu main idenya. Everyone can get freedom. Topiknya freedom. Ya, yeah, oke. Okay. Jadi semua orang bisa mendapatkan kebebasan. Right. Freedom. Berarti gimana? Freedom mean for me is we can do something without we scared.
Can do something without scared.
For me, koma, gitu ya. Atau Anda bisa kalau mau lebih akademik lagi, in my view, gitu. Bisa begitu. In my view atau in my perspective, boleh pakai frase itu. Gak apa-apa. Nanti kan recorded, Anda bisa ini. For me, freedom, in my perspective, freedom means, kan gitu. Means we can do something without any scares. Tanpa ketakutan. Gitu ya. Untuk membuat kalimat itu efektif. Kalau Anda pakai we lagi di situ, seakan-akan kurang efektif. Kalau menurut saya sih. For me, freedom means we can do something without scare, without any scare about something. Like my experience, itu spellingnya. Spellingnya perlu diperbaiki. Like my experience, comma, I got my freedom. Why? Bukan saya ketuk-ketuk. I got my freedom. Sebentar. There is a problem with the LCD. Dah? Okay. Like my experience, I got my freedom. Gimana membuat kalimat ini efektif? Like my experience.
In my experience.
Huh? Go on.
In my experience.
I can.
Gini-gini. In my life, I got my freedom by going to Malang. Masukkan parents ya. In my life, I got my freedom from my parents as the one who holds my as the one who holds the freedom of my life by going to Malang. gitu ya. Do you think so? Atau ada yang punya kalimat yang lebih efektif? In my life, I got my freedom from my parents, the in ones who would... Boleh? In my case, I got my freedom from my parents.
Abroad
di luar negeri. Ya gitu. Jadi in my life I got the freedom from my family who holds the freedom of my life by going. Terus koma. Anda tahu penggunaan apositif? Apositif itu koma dua. Teman-teman bisa lihat ya. Jadi koma dua. Can you spot this?
Soeharto.
Koma, siapa?
The former president. The former president of Indonesia. Koma.
Apa?
Was one of the greatest
apa military apa gitu apa greatest leader misalnya gitu. Nah ini fungsinya disebut apositif, ini menerangkan ini. So maksudnya Soeharto itu siapa sih? Soeharto itu the former president of Indonesia.
Koma ini kalimatnya sebenarnya cuma gini doang. Cuma ini kayak ejected gitu loh. Dia menerangkan siapa sih Soeharto. Jadi kalau ini pun di delete nggak apa-apa. Kan inti kalimatnya ada di sini. Soeharto was one of the greatest leaders. One of the greatest leaders.
Itu ya. Tahu apositif ya. Nah sama seperti si Mas ini tadi. In my life, I got my freedom from my parents. Terus di gini kan, the ones who hold apa tadi? Who hold apa? Who hold my absolute freedom misalnya gitu. Itu hanya menerangkan siapa sih parents? Oh, yang memberi kebebasan, gitu ya. Bisa begitu. Lalu kalimat selanjutnya adalah by going to Malang. Gitu. Titik. What I can get from my experience. Nah, ini kalimatnya perlu diperbaiki. Can you please fix, Mas Akbar? What I can get from my experience. Kok tiba-tiba koma, terus if you want to get some freedom, is just leave your phone. Mau bilang apa, Mas Akbar?
Apa yang saya dapatkan dari mama saya? Kalau kamu mau mendapatkan suatu kebebasan, tinggalkan,
holder. Kayaknya Mas ini perlu sense-nya gitu kan kalau kita bahasa Indonesia. Apa yang saya dapatkan dari
pengalaman saya?
Kalau kamu padahal enggak ada struktur itu di bahasa Inggris. Di bahasa Inggris kan if-nya di belakang berarti harus berkaitan. Kalau hujan saya enggak masuk. Saya enggak masuk kalau hujan. Karena hujan. Kan gitu kalimatnya. Nah ini what I can get itu nggak selaras dengan if you. Apa sih kalimat lain? If you. Kalau saya kaya, saya beli rumah dua. Saya beli rumah dua kalau saya kaya. Jadi kan struktur kalimatnya gitu. Lagi Mas Akbar, kalimat pertamanya what I can do from my freedoms. Tadi apa tadi? Lalu if you want. Jadi masih kebawa bahasa tuturnya bahasa Indonesia, gitu ya? Oke. Nanti Mas Akbar bisa fix itu. Lalu, freedom is very fun because no one can stop you to do something. Boleh? Itu conclusions-nya. Detailnya diperbaiki lagi. Ini pakai detail yang mana? Explanation. Gak apa-apa, explanation sih berarti. Explanation. Oke, gitu teman-teman. Ada pertanyaan? Tidak ada. Oke, you can stop sharing, Mas Adam. Sorry, Adam lagi Akbar. Oke, harapannya setelah ini saya akhiri sampai di sini, kita ada sampai 11.10, teman-teman nggak sampai 11.10. Kalau toh teman-teman masih belum mengerjakan, belum membuat paragrafnya, nggak apa-apa. Yang penting hari ini disubmit di LMS ya, nanti saya buatkan linknya. Oke, ada yang ditanyakan sebelum kita akhiri? It's all good. Topiknya mengikuti topik yang kemarin itu? Yang unit berapa itu? Unit 3? Halaman 19. Nomor 6. Ada beberapa topik, silahkan dipilih satu untuk dikembangkan menjadi paragraf yang bagus. Utamanya adalah yang Anda fokuskan topik sentence, kemudian supporting details. Supporting details-nya pakai 3 cara. Salah satunya details, explanations, dan juga example. Silahkan pakai salah satu dari itu. Oke, okay. Kemudian jangan lupa concluding sentence. Alright, that's all. Di submit hari ini bisa ya? Terus kapan? Teman-teman yang online bisa hari ini atau unit? Rebecca? What do you think? Can you submit today?
Ya, yeah, bisa, ma'am.
Ya, yeah, bisa. Rebecca aja bisa loh. Ayo, berarti yang lain juga harus bisa. Oke. Okay. Berarti hari ini terserah sampai jam berapa? Kalau bisa hari ini. Next meeting, Jumat, kita bahas satu atau dua, lalu kita lanjutkan materinya. Gitu ya. Oke. Okay. Thank you very much for your all active participation. See you around, everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, ma'am.
Alhamdulillah hari ini internetnya lancar.